Alright, we have come to the end of this series where I do five simple cocktails where all you need is one spirit. And we are going to finish up with probably the most accessible spirit out there, vodka. So I'm going to show you five delicious cocktails that are incredibly easy to make at home, but maybe a bit more complex than the standard screwdriver.
That is vodka, and I mixed it with orange juice. I call it an orange vodjuska.
Right, of course, the orange vodjuska. Okay, well, let's get to it. Starting off, we're going to do the lemon drop. And while there are a few different variations on how to make this, we're going to do the basic sour template here, starting with 3/4 of an ounce or 22 mils of fresh lemon juice. Next up, we need to balance that out with 3/4 of an ounce or 22 mils of simple syrup. And next, we need our vodka. And don't be rushing to pour here. Measure out 2 ounces or 60 mils. Now we're going to shake that with ice for about 15 seconds to chill and dilute it. This drink originated in sort of the dark age of cocktails in the 1970s and was originally made with triple sec and vodka citron. But just like with the Tommy's margarita from my last video, sometimes simpler is better. Alright, grab yourself a chilled coupe glass and then we're just going to double strain that to filter out any pulp or small ice chips. It's nice to give these simple cocktails a bit of a garnish, so we're just going to express the oils of a lemon peel over the top, wipe the rim, and drop it in. Alright, this is your lemon drop. Basic sour template using vodka, and it's really refreshing. Really clean, super well balanced, it's kind of like a boozy lemonade. It's not very challenging, this would be like your cocktail on training wheels. Alright, next up, the classic vodka cocktail with a bit of a kick, the Moscow Mule, one of my favorites. You can use a copper mug if you like, but I'm just going to go with a Collins glass and fill it up with ice. Now I'm regretting burning my terrible Russian joke with the first cocktail, but what can I say? Ugh, terrible. I find this drink really needs a bit of citrus, and I just kind of eyeball half a lime squeeze in here. You could use lemon if you prefer, but it's up to you. Now you may have seen my other Moscow Mule video where I used some fresh ginger syrup, which is excellent, but in the spirit of keeping things simple, I'm just going to use some ginger beer. Now, I like a pretty spicy ginger beer, it's why I usually go with Fever Tree or Q brand, and we're shooting for about 4 ounces or 120 mils. Then just drop in a sippy cylinder, give that a little stir, garnish that with a cute little baby Yoda ear, and let's give it a taste, the classic Moscow Mule. This is just an excellent cocktail template, spicy, sweet, a little sour. You could actually swap out the vodka for pretty much any spirit here, and it's gonna work really well. Alright, for those of you getting over your quarantine bods, we have the low-cal and delicious cucumber mint vodka soda. And call me Pumbaa, because we're doing Hakuna Mavodka, 2 ounces or 60 mils into a chilled Collins glass. Cut up about 3 or 4 cucumber slices, drop them in the glass. Alright, let's head to the Herb Keeper to select some mint, and yes sir, you are the lucky one today. We're gonna pull off about 4 or 5 leaves. And now we're just going to grab a muddler and gently muddle these together. So we're not trying to pulverize and shred the mint or crush the cucumber. We're just trying to extract some of the juices and the mint oils. Top it off with some ice. Now we need to top this off with some bubbly. I'm a big fan of the Topo Chico mineral water here. So we're just going for about 3 or 4 ounces or 120 to 150 mils. Grab yourself a sippy cylinder, twirl it, swirl it, mix it all together. Dress that up with a little bouquet of mint, and there you have the cleverly named cucumber mint vodka soda. And honestly, that is super refreshing. You get that mint on the nose. That cucumber flavor really comes through. It's clean, simple, tasty. Love it. Next up, we got this fruity and delicious gem from King Cocktail himself, Dale DeGroff, the Grapefruit Julep. We're going to start with some honey syrup made with equal parts honey and water by volume and add 3/4 of an ounce or 22 mils to a shaker glass. Grab a few junior varsity mint leaves that didn't make the first cut, throw them into the shaker glass and gently muddle to express some of the oils. To balance that out, we're going to throw in 1/2 ounce or about 15 mils of fresh lime juice, then 1.5 ounces or about 45 mils of fresh grapefruit juice. And then we need some pomegranate juice, 1 ounce or 30 mils. And more vodka? Absolutely. We're gonna add 2 ounces or 60 mils into the shaker glass and then shake for about 15 seconds with ice to chill and dilute it. Next, we need some cracked ice here, so we're gonna put some ice into a Lewis bag and beat the devil out of it. Pour it into a chilled Collins glass. Then double strain your cocktail over the top, and it's this beautiful deep red color. Top it off with a bit more ice, drop in a little mint sprig for garnish, and let's give it a taste, the grapefruit julep. First off, it smells excellent with the mint on the nose, and this drink is super flavorful. There's a ton going on here, lots of juices, lots of flavor. Sort of like a boozy adult fruit punch. It's delicious. All right, and finally, I came up with a pretty amazing original cocktail. I can't think of a name, so we're gonna go with the Stravodberica. This is a pretty simple cocktail. We're gonna start with half an ounce or 15 mils of that honey syrup. Pour it into a shaker glass. Grab a couple strawberries, cut them in half, drop them into the shaker tin, and then using your muddler, extract a lot of the juices from those strawberries into that honey syrup. To balance that out, we're gonna do 3/4 of an ounce, or about 22 mils of fresh lime juice. Did I tell you guys I tried a vodka diet once? I lost 3 days. Hey, dad joke. All right, 2 ounces or 60 mils. All right, y'all know the drill by now. Throw some ice in there, give it a little smack, a little shake and bake, and then we're gonna double strain that into a chilled coupe glass. Then we're just gonna top that with a bit of spicy ginger beer, give that a bit of a strawberry garnish, and let's see if this thing is any good. Cheers. Honestly, this is delicious. The ginger beer hits you on the nose right away, but that strawberry flavor comes through really nicely, pairs excellently with that honey syrup, and the vodka just kind of takes a back seat. So I'm really excited that this video was sponsored by StayKeen.com. Keen is a place to keep all of your interests together, and it helps keep them alive by recommending things that are relevant to each interest. As you might have noticed, I've been making a lot of videos around simple cocktails based on one spirit, like whiskey, rum, or tequila. So I've actually made a Keen linking to all of those cocktail videos, as well as other fun articles relevant to that topic. What's cool about Keen is that when I save content to this list, it makes it better at finding related content like this across the web and makes it really easy to share your interests with friends. So go ahead and follow my Keen. I'll put a link in the description below, or you can try making your own at staykeen.com. And if you found it helpful, just let me know in the comments below. Again, big thanks to Keen for sponsoring this video. Cheers, y'all.